Alfred Prince Edwards, born July 6, 2001, is a filmmaker, artist, and photographer based out of New York City. Throughout his years of high school, Alfred sought out to gain experience in the film industry, finally finding employment in 2018 through a mixed media company based in Brooklyn, Hook Arts Media.
Okay, hi. Thank you for sitting down with me, given all the circumstances that we're going through right now. Could you just take a second and introduce yourself?
Yeah, for sure. My name is Alfred Edwards, and I'm you.
So, for my first question, I was just wondering, if you had one word to describe quarantine, what would it be?
I don't know. I feel like this whole process for quarantine has been really confusing as to what the way I feel towards it, I guess.
No, I can definitely see where you're coming from. There's like a huge blur at the moment between like the different sides. Some people want to stay in while other people just really want to go out. So it's really easy to get confused as to like where you stand. So for my next question, I was just kind of wondering what you've been doing to keep yourself busy. Since during this whole quarantine thing, it can get really easy to fall into the same patterns, just doing the same thing day after day.
I don't know. I've been trying to be productive through different things, like editing, for example. I've been trying out a few new effects that I'm definitely excited to show people. Skating is another thing that I've definitely tried to pick up. Wherever I go, I'll just try to skate around, just have fun with it, and try to improve before summer comes. Hopefully, we're out of this by then.
Well, I think we've gone over the time limit here, so thank you again for sitting down with me and answering these questions. For many years, New York City has been a massive trendsetter for art around the globe. Supreme New York, created by James Jebbia in 1994 in the Soho District of Manhattan, is a prime example of this phenomenon. You've probably heard about the brand through the internet, word of mouth, or even visiting one of the stores. The brand being so well known in the public eye is to be expected, given that Supreme's expanded far beyond New York City, having stores in LA, Paris, London, and Tokyo to name a few of the locations. One of the downsides to the hype around the brand is their long lines. Supreme has customers line up in front of their stores every week for a new release through reservation. Even casual shoppers or tourists have to abide by this release method. So, what do the people behind the brand and the people actually waiting in these lines think?
How do you feel about the kids who like are sleeping outside, getting rained on?
I think God bless them. You know what I mean? Like, it's putting food on my table. I'm pretty sure if I was 15, I'd be online too. Kids are out there, you know, connecting and politicking, and you know, I feel like the lines now have become like the new record, like the record shop.
Some people even travel large distances just to get a space online to secure the latest items.
I was like, yeah, I came in from Chicago. I was like, yeah, I came in from Indonesia. I think that beats me.
Just flew out like yesterday. I reached in the morning. I need to fly back again at night.
Overall, based on these comments, it seems like the popularity of Supreme will only increase from here on out.
I got you stuck off the realness. We be the infamous, you heard of us. Official Queensbridge murderers. The mob comes equipped for warfare. Beware of my crime family who got enough shots to share for all those who wanna profile and pose. Rock you in your face, stab your brain with your nose bone. You all alone in these streets, cousin. Every man for himself in his land. We be gunning and keep them shook crews running like they supposed to.